London, and welcome to The Forge. I'm Lady Davinia from Absolution UK, the London division, here with Then Come Silence again, Alex, Hugo, and Jonas. Welcome, guys. Welcome back.
Thank you.
It's been 6 months.
Yeah.
Since your last.
6 months.
Is it? A small interruption. We'll continue. Okay, 6 months is the natural interview. 6 months since your last visit, much colder now. The first thing I noticed, and I noticed on your Facebook page, is that there's one person missing.
Yeah.
One person less.
It's not missing, there's one person less.
Yeah. So basically now it's just the three of you.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to tell me any details? What's happened, or don't you?
We'll save that for the biography.
Okay, so you're basically now a trio.
Yeah, we are. Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Are you in the process of looking for another fourth member, a new member, or not?
Not at the moment.
We thought about it first for like a. All the songs are basically written for a four piece band. So for a long time we thought it would be totally impossible to do it as a trio. But. Had to try it out in the US.
Hugo's got more on his shoulders now than he does, hasn't he?
Yeah. How do you feel about that?
It's terrible.
It's terrible, right? Yeah. I'm sure you can manage though.
I'm trying. Let's see. But the thing is that we were forced to do it in the US.
Yes, I know that it was just from what I saw, most of your gigs in the US from the tour that you had last year. It was just you two.
Yeah.
Mainly, and you used some of the members from Bellwether.
Yeah.
Okay. So basically you're already like, you know, seeing what that would be like with, you know, less members.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe that's why we decided to just go on as a trio. Because we already tried it a little bit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So and it worked.
Basically before that when we talked about it, it was like, no, we can do it.
So it wasn't basically a sudden thing?
No.
So that's the first thing that I wanted to ask, because I was looking at some pictures on Facebook. There's somebody missing. Okay, fair enough. Okay, so you are back in the UK, back in London. This is your third time.
Third time.
I've done my homework. You played Electroworks in 2019.
Yeah, but you know, my life is divided pre-corona and post-corona.
Okay, well, in general, this is your third time in the UK, and
totally.
Tomorrow you guys are also playing in Bristol.
Yeah.
Is it your first time in Bristol?
My first time. I don't know about you.
Yeah.
It's
a lovely city.
Yeah?
It's a lovely city, yes. One question I do want to ask. I do believe that you probably wanted to have some more UK shows. I suppose that's on the cards for maybe your fourth time in the UK?
Yeah.
It's not that easy, I know.
The thing is, we'd love to do a longer tour, of course. But you know, we can't really bring our instruments if they stop us at the customs, so we have to pay tax for things we already own. And so we decided to do it like this. We travel light, and then we borrow stuff
rent
it for us.
It's much easier. It's much cheaper probably to rent.
A little bit, and. But if we're doing a tour, it's a little bit more complicated because then we have to bring everything with us. But let's see what happens. Maybe next trip we'll
try and put some more shows in.
We can figure out how to do it with rented gear and backline.
Okay, so
we're working on it.
It is on the cards.
Absolutely.
It was really fun when we played with 1919.
Oh yeah. 2019,
that was a complete
trip.
Tour. You did how many shows back then?
Five, six. It wasn't a long, it was a week. a bit different. US, apart from Europe, but I think the crowd is just so lovely. So you immediately you feel that you want to go back.
They're very friendly, the Americans.
Extremely friendly and very, how to say,
enthusiastic.
Very enthusiastic,
yeah.
Yeah.
And they give you energy. The crowd's very good at giving you energy.
Is there one particular city you guys played in that kind of like stuck out for you guys, that you felt more that enthusiasm, or was it all the same?
Motor Cross, New York, that was amazing.
Different album from your previous, what you released. It's a post-pandemic album. What Spirits That I Called from 2017, but you remixed that.
And the remix is actually pre-corona, so it was before the pandemic, so it's actually an old one.
Is that something that interests you guys, like to remix other people's music?
Not at all. No.
Not at all. No. Okay, so then how did that come about then?
You know, sometimes we do that for you know, friends or someone who's really, really nagging.
Okay. Oh, they're pestering you then. Okay, so another question. Would you like other people to remix your stuff?
Not at all.
Okay.
Well, if
someone offered, they said, we'll do a remix album and then come Silence Fest or whatever.
If it sounds okay, then okay, fine with me.
I mean, we don't care if someone would do it. I don't think we would force someone to come to it, but we would never ask for it. Or like,
yeah, we have actually some people asking for it, and it's not on my priority list.
It's not something that you really want, but if you're really pestering about it, guys, this is a short interview with a few interruptions, a bit quieter than last time.
Yeah.
Not very quiet, just a little bit. It was quiet last time, anyway.
Last time was worse.
Yeah, last time we had it was up here, now it's on the side. Last time it was on the ceiling. Yeah. Okay, well, it was lovely seeing you guys again.
Yeah, the same. It was lovely seeing you.
And I hope you have a great show. I hope to see you at the after party at the Div. Later.
Yeah, it's going to be a long night.
It's going to be a long night, yes. And I hope you have a great show in Bristol tomorrow and enjoy that. And hopefully do a little bit of sightseeing in Bristol if you have time.
I think we have at least 1 hour.
At least 1 hour, that's enough. Okay.
Yeah, take a walk.
There's a nice fish and chip shop on a boat that you must go to.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
But nothing for the soul.
Yeah, we have bad experience.
Yeah, in Manchester, we fish and chips before the show and it was terrible.
Yeah,
maybe after the show then.
Yeah.
Okay. And I hope to see you guys very, very soon, either here or some European show. We'll see, because I do know you've got lots of upcoming stuff.
Yeah, we have upcoming in shows in May in Germany. Finally, because we know we have...
WGT?
No, we played last year.
Yes, I saw you last year.
Yeah, so we can't play this year, but we have a lot of German fans.
Yes, I know you cancelled.
And they're quite annoyed, and we're not that popular with them anymore because of that. So
it's not your fault.
No, it's not our fault, but we have to like bring it back now. So
you will.
Yeah, you know, like, yeah.
Okay. So, well, thank you once again, guys. Good night from me. Good night from Jonas, Hugo, and Alex, and I will see you very soon.
It's Thank You Silence. Big room and Thank You Silence. Thank you.